ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். டுடே இஸ் ஆவணி ரோஹிணி. இன் அடிஷன் டு ஸ்ரீ ஜெயந்தி, கிருஷ்ணஸ் திருநக்ஷத்திரம் பீயிங் செலிப்ரேட்டட், வி ஆல்சோ செலிப்ரேட் அ வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் அக்கேஷன் டுடே. டுடே இஸ் தி டே வென் பெரியவாச்சான் பிள்ளை டுக் பர்த் இன் திஸ் வேர்ல்ட். Let us enjoy his life and glories now. Periyavachan Pillai was born in Sanganallur. Today this place is known as Senganur. This is near Kumbakonam. When he was born, his parents named him Krishna. There is an interesting incident which our elders explain as an anubhavam. There is a relationship between Krishna and Periyavachan Pillai. Of course, both were born in Avani Rohini. Beyond that, in Tirukkannamangai, Tirumangai Aalvar submits 10 Pasurams in Periya Thirumuli in 7th centum. This is the final decade of the centum. In the last Pasuram, Tirumangai Aalvar says to Emperuman in Tirukkannamangai, Nindanakkum Kurippagil Karkalam Kaviyin Poruldane. This is shown as an interesting conversation between Emperuman and Aalvar. Aalvar says, if you are interested, you can learn the meanings of this decade as well. Perumal asks Aalvar, yes, I am very much interested in knowing the meanings. Why don't you teach me? And Aalvar says, I cannot teach you just like that. You have to come like a disciple, like a student to me and then learn. That is the standard procedure. Hearing that, Emperuman says, I cannot do it in this archa form. I will take birth in this world. I will incarnate as a personality, as an individual, and I will come and learn from you. So it is said that Bhagavan Krishna appeared as Periyavachan Pillai and Tirumangai Aalvar reincarnated as Nampillai. Nampillai was the great Acharya who was in Sri Rangam delivering wonderful lectures on our Sampradayam principles. He was a great scholar, very highly intellectual person. He was born in Kartigai Kartigai, which is the same birth star as Tirumangai Aalvar. And Periyavachan Pillai, his disciple, Nambillai's disciple, was born in Avani Rohini, which is Krishna's Tirunakshatram. Because of this match in their Tirunakshatrams and their roles, our elders present this enjoyable connection and narration. Periyavachan Pillai becomes disciple of Nampillai and learns all our Sampradayam principles from Nampillai. Nampillai, being pleased with Periyavachan Pillai's learnings, orders Periyavachan Pillai to write commentaries for Divya Prabandham. Periyavachan Pillai composes commentaries for all of the Divya Prabandhams and submits them to Nampillai. Nampillai approves of them and they become the standard tool to learn the meanings of Divya Prabandham. Not only Divya Prabandhams, Periyachan Pillai also wrote commentaries for Stotra Granthams of our Purvacharyas. For example, Stotra Ratnam, Chatushloki of Alavandar, Gadyatrayam of Emberamanar, Jitate Stotram, which is part of Vedam. All of these were explained in detail in the form of Vyakhyanam, commentaries by Periyachan Pillai. He was also an expert in Sri Ramayanam. Being a disciple of Nampillai facilitates one to learn Sri Ramayanam in a very deep manner, and having mastered it, Periyachan Pillai writes commentaries for important shlokams from Sri Ramayanam, and he writes elaborate commentary for the section where Vibhishana performs Sharanagati to Sri Rama, and Sri Rama accepts him. This acceptance of Vibhishana's Sharanagati is called Abhayaprada, Abhayapradhanam, giving protection to Vibhishana by Rama. Because of his masterly commentary, Periyachan Pillai is given the title Abhayaprada Rajar, one who is an expert in this Sharanagati principle. Earlier, he was also celebrated as Vyakhyana Chakravarti, emperor of commentators, because of his ability to write elaborate and elegant commentaries. He also composed certain Rahasya Granthams such as Manika Malai, Parandarahasyam and so on, which bring out the deep philosophical points of our Sampradayam. In this manner, Periyachan Pillai composed wonderful works, literature, for the benefit of all of humanity. He also composed a beautiful Sri Ramayanam, which is known as Pasurapadi Ramayanam. This is composed based on words from Divya Prabandham. The story of Sri Ramayanam is narrated using the words of Divya Prabandham. A wonderful masterpiece of Periyachan Pillai. His greatness can also be understood from a beautiful incident in his life. A disciple of Periyachan Pillai was serving in Periyachan Pillai's Tirumadaipalli kitchen. He was not very learned, but by the grace of Periyachan Pillai, he becomes to be a great scholar. Once, he observes that a few Sri Vaishnava scholars were discussing on some topic. So he goes to them and asks what they were discussing about. Knowing well that he is not a knowledgeable person, those Sri Vaishnavas made fun of him and drove him away. He went straight to Periyachan Pillai and told what happened. Periyachan Pillai showered his mercy upon his disciple and told, "You have not learnt Shastram and Sampradayam so far, but starting today I will teach you and you will become a scholar." And based on the learnings, he quickly becomes a wonderful scholar. He also becomes very detached from worldly life and hence accepts sannyasa ashramam. He becomes to be known as Vadikesari Aligevanavara Jiyar and goes on to write wonderful commentaries for many of our Purvacharya works. This shows the power of Acharya's mercy, Periyachan Pillai blessing his disciple to become a great scholar in this manner. Just as Periya Perumal, Periya Pirati, Periya Thiruvadi and so on, some of these wonderful personalities have this அட்ஜெக்டிவ் பெரிய இன் தேர் நேம் ஹைலைட்டிங் தேர் கிரேட்னஸ். ஹியர் ஆச்சான் பிள்ளை இஸ் நோன் அஸ் பெரிய ஆச்சான் பிள்ளை, நோயிங் மேனிஃபெஸ்டிங் ஹிஸ் கிரேட்னஸ் டு எவ்ரி ஒன். மணவாள மாமனிகள் கிரேட்லி குளோரிஃபைஸ் பெரிய ஆச்சான் பிள்ளை இன் உபதேச ரத்தின மாலை. இன் ஒன் பாசுரம் மணவாள் மாமனிகள் ஹைலைட்ஸ் ஹவு பெரிய ஆச்சான் பிள்ளை ரோட் 24,000 படி காமெண்ட்ரி ஃபார் திருவாய்மொழி. இன் அனதர் பாசுரம் மணவாள் மாமனிகள் பிரிங்ஸ் அவுட் தி ஃபுல் கிரேட்னஸ் ஆஃப் பெரியவாச்சான் பிள்ளை. பெரியவாச்சான் பிள்ளை பின்புள்ள வைக்கும் தெரிய வியாக்கியைகள் செய்வால் அரிய அருளிச் செயல் பொருளை ஆரியர்கட்கு போது அருளிச் செயலாய் தெரிந்து. இட் இஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தி காமெண்ட்ரிஸ் ஆஃப் பெரியவாச்சான் பிள்ளை டுடே வி ஆல் நோ வாட் இஸ் தி ரியல் மீனிங் ஆஃப் திவ்ய பிரபந்தம் சேஸ் மணவாள மாமனிகள். இன் திஸ் மேனர் பெரியவாச்சான் பிள்ளைஸ் கிரேட்னஸ் இஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டுட் த்ரூ தி வேர்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் கிரேட் ஸ்காலர்ஸ். ஹி ஹேட் அன் அடாப்டட் சன் நோன் ஆஸ் நாயனார் ஆச்சான் பிள்ளை ஹூ இஸ் ஒன் ஆஃப் ஹிஸ் பிரைம் டிசைபிள்ஸ். பரகால தாசர், வாதிகேஸ்வரி அழகிய மணவாழ்ச்சியர் வேர் ஆல்சோ பெரியவாச்சான் பிள்ளைஸ் டிசைபிள்ஸ். A few incidents from the life of Periyavachan Pillai is documented in granthams such as Vartamala. Let us see and enjoy a few of them. Once, a Sri Vaishnava goes to Periyavachan Pillai and asks if we are target of Emperuman's Kripa, his mercy, or Emperuman's Leela, his sport. For that, Periyavachan Pillai beautifully gives an answer. If we consider ourselves as being caught in this bondage, samsara, if we consider ourselves suffering in samsara, then we will become the target of Bhagavan's mercy. But if we consider to be part of this Leela, if we enjoy this samsara, then we will become target of his Leela, his sport. The whole of creation, sustenance, annihilation, the repeated cycle of samsara is happening for the sport of Bhagavan, for the Leela of Bhagavan. If we consider ourselves to be part of this, then we will also remain part of this. But if we consider that we don't belong here, we don't enjoy being here, rather we are suffering, then we will be freed from this by Bhagavan's mercy. In another incident, a Sri Vaishnava comes and asks Periyavachan Pillai, what is Paratantriya, total subservience? For that, Periyavachan Pillai explains that one should not depend on one's own strength, rather one should be fully dependent on Bhagavan's strength and abilities. One should not have any attachment towards any means, karma yoga, jnana yoga, bhakti yoga and so on, and should consider Bhagavan's divine feet as the only means. And finally, one should crave for eternal kaikaryam to Bhagavan in Paramapadam. When one is in such state, one can be said to be fully dependent on Bhagavan and fully in Paratantriya. In another incident, Periyavachan Pillai observes a Sri Vaishnava finding faults in another Sri Vaishnava. At that time he explains, there are only three persons who can find the fault of anyone. Yama, Yama Dharmaraja, Pirati, and Bhagavan. Only these three are qualified to look at the faults and punish or reform the individual. But even those three are ignoring the faults of Sri Vaishnavas, those who are surrendered to Bhagavan. Yama Dharmaraja tells his servants that when you see a Sri Vaishnava, you move away from him. Don't look at his faults. Pirati tells, Nakaschin Naparadyati, who doesn't commit mistakes? So let's not look at the mistakes of others. Bhagavan says, if my devotee commits a mistake, even that will be for a good reason. So if these three personalities are ignoring the faults of Sri Vaishnavas, why are you finding faults in this particular Sri Vaishnava? Such was the beautiful explanation of Periyavachan Pillai when he observed a Sri Vaishnava finding fault in another person, another Sri Vaishnava. In this manner, we have enjoyed the life and glories of Periyavachan Pillai. Aalvar Emberumanar G.L. Thiruvadigale Sharanam, G.L. Thiruvadigale Sharanam.
Please download our Koil, K-O-Y-I-L app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store to listen to or download Upanyasams like these. Our website portal is koyil.org. Koil.org.